In this video, we cover the most basic points that a physicist should know about group theory. Along the way, we'll give you lots of examples that illustrate each step. So let's start with a definition. A group is a set of elements, G, like A, B, C, and so on, together with a binary operation, circle, that fulfill four properties. You might wonder, what is this circle operator, which is also sometimes called the group law? But that's the whole point. If you define a group, you have to specify a set G, as well as what exactly this circle operator is. For instance, if we take the set of real numbers and take the binary operation as addition, then this could be a group. Why could be? Well, in order to decide whether R plus is a group or not, we first have to check those properties we mentioned earlier. So let's do that now. First, closure. If A and B are elements of G, then A circle B is also an element of G. Let's take this R plus as an example. If you take any two real numbers and add them together, the result will absolutely again be a real number. And what about a counterexample? Well, if you consider the set of numbers between 0 and 1 with addition, then it could happen that after adding two numbers, it will be greater than 1. Therefore, this cannot be a group. Second, associativity. If we compute three elements, then it should make no difference where we put the brackets. Whether we first evaluate the second and third, or the first and second elements first. This should hold for any elements A, B, C in G. An example could be again R plus, and the counterexample could be the vector space R3 together with the vector cross product. Third, the identity element. There exists an element E in G, so that A circle E is equal to A for all A in G. Strictly speaking, this is a right identity, but in physics we usually don't have to worry about right and left identities. What is important though is that the identity element is unique. To prove this, let's assume that E1 and E2 are both identity elements. Then E1 is equal to E1 circle E2, since E2 is an identity. But since E1 is also an identity, this is equal to E2, and we see that E1 must be the same as E2. To give you an example of an identity element, let's take the set of whole numbers, Z, together with multiplication. In this case, the identity element is 1, since we can always multiply any number with 1 and it stays the same. And since 1 is an element of Z, this might be a group. For a counterexample, consider R++. For addition, the identity element is 0, but 0 is not in R+. Therefore, this cannot be a group. Finally, the inverse element. There exists some element A-1 in G, so that A circle A-1 is equal to the identity element for all A in G. Again, strictly speaking, this is a right inverse, but let's not worry about that. Instead, let us show that the inverse element is also unique. For any given A in G, there is only one A-1. But let's assume that there would be an A-1 and then A-1, and that they both are inverses of A. If we start with A-1, this is equal to A-1 circle the identity element. Next, we replace the identity element with A circle A-1. By using associativity, we can move the brackets and first evaluate those terms. They give the identity element, which means that A-1 is equal to A-1. For an example of the inverse element, consider Z+. In this case, the inverse element of any number is given by the negative of that number. For a counterexample, consider Z with a multiplication, so that the inverse of A is simply 1 divided by A. But 1 over A is not in Z for most cases of A, so this cannot be a group. Additionally, there can be one more condition which is important in physics, but not necessary to define a group, commutativity. If, for any two elements A, B in G, A circle B is equal to B circle A, the group is called an Abelian group. named after the Norwegian mathematician Niels Henrik Abel. A famous example of non-abelian groups are those where the circle operator corresponds to matrix multiplication. Since for matrices, it's usually important whether you multiply AB or BA. So that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.